Hey guys, it's the Movie Buff Pains, and we're back again with another video. Today we're going to be talking about our 10 favorite films of all time. We've had a few people request this video, and it's actually one that we intended on doing very early on in our YouTube careers, but I'm kind of indecisive when it comes to this list, so I've been putting it off. It goes without saying, this list could probably change depending on the day that you ask us, but overall, we love all of these films on our list.
Definitely. We were both able to settle down on a top 10, but we also both have a few honorable mentions because it was just too difficult, honestly, to try and narrow it down that much.
Yeah, so I have 5 honorable mentions as well as my top 10, and I will say none of them are ranked. I think that would just make this even more difficult than it already is. So
yeah, same goes for me. 10 favorites along with 5 honorable mentions, and yeah, ranking these things is just, that's too much to ask of us. Just narrowing it down to 15 movies to share each was a task in itself, so.
It sure was. And since I'm always talking so much, I'll go ahead and let you go first.
All right, I'll start with my honorable mentions. First one up I have is Star Wars. I absolutely love this series, but the original Star Wars was definitely what made me just fall in love, especially with science fiction. I've watched that since I was a kid. It'll always be amongst one of my favorite movies just for introducing me to such an amazing genre.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised that didn't make your top 10, to be honest.
Yeah, it was tough. It was tough to decide what went where.
My first honorable mention is Blowout, directed by Brian De Palma, starring John Travolta and Nancy Allen. I'm sure this comes as no surprise to you. I talk about how much I love this movie all the time. I think in the future, it probably will end up in my top 10. But right now, I've only seen it a couple times and just not quite there yet, but I absolutely love this film. Brian De Palma has such an incredible skill at building tension and just creating a mystery that you're fully invested in. And Blowout is no exception. The sound design is wonderful. The performances are great. I'm fully invested the entire time. It's just such an engaging film. I absolutely love it. And I just recently showed you that one, so.
Yeah, that was a good one. My next honorable mention would have to be Ratatouille, one of my favorite Pixar films, and it is just an amazing film all around. I love the story, I love the animation. I think the biggest thing I love about it is the soundtrack, definitely. It's one of my favorite film soundtracks. The score is just wonderful. And so it definitely is up there, probably even for one of my favorite animated films. It didn't quite crack the top 10 for me there, but it definitely is deserving of the honorable mention.
And I'm sure we'll see a few other animated films on your list. All right, my next honorable mention is RoboCop, directed by Paul Verhoeven. Going into this film, I'd heard many things about it over the years, and I did not expect to love it, but I absolutely loved it. It blew me away. Really surprised me, because it's one of those films that everybody knows, but it's wonderful. It's one of the best sci-fi films of all time. Another really good example of tension and suspense, and just so good. I love everything about RoboCop. And hey, another film that stars Nancy Allen.
My next honorable mention is The Way, Way Back. This movie introduced me to independent film, honestly, and you showed me this one pretty early on in our dating life. Mm-hmm. And I've never really seen anything that had the feel of an independent film. I'd always just seen big blockbusters and stuff, mainstream stuff of the theaters. So this movie was so different and so small scale and kind of more of a personal story that it just captivated me. And I will always be grateful for having seen that movie. Thank you.
You're welcome. But yeah, that's a great film. I'm actually surprised that's not somewhere on my list, but yeah, that's a wonderful movie. This next honorable mention, in the past it has been in my top 10. It got slightly edged out by some of the others this time. However, it's a film I absolutely love, directed by Cameron Crowe, and that's Almost Famous. This is one of the all-time great road movies, coming-of-age stories, and just an overall wonderful film. Kate Hudson's great in it, Patrick Fugit is really great and kind of an introductory role for him, but I think the real standout performance is from Billy Crudup. He's really, really good in this, and I think this may have been one of the first things that I saw with him, and I was really impressed. But yeah, Almost Famous, one of my all-time favorite coming-of-age films, and the music is great. It's just a great movie from Cameron Crowe.
I almost had that one on my list as well. I like it that much, but it got edged out by some other stuff, honestly, but it was close to being on my list as well.
Yeah, I've wondered if we would have any common films in our list, but I don't think we will, to be honest.
We probably won't.
But yeah, Almost Famous was one that I thought you might have on your list somewhere, but yeah, I love that movie.
My next honorable mention is Chef. This was another sort of early introduction to independent film for me. I just absolutely love the story and soundtrack on this movie as well. It is just one of my kind of go-to feel-good movies because there's really no serious conflict in the film. It's a pretty easy ride through the whole thing. And again, yeah, it's just definitely one of my go-tos if I just want something that'll really brighten my day up.
Yeah, and there's a lot of really delicious looking food in that movie.
The food in that movie.
Yeah, definitely don't watch it on an empty stomach. My next honorable mention is a film by Martin Scorsese, and that is The Departed. I think overall this is my favorite Scorsese film, although I really love a lot of his movies. He's an acclaimed director for a reason. He has just made a bunch of really great films. But The Departed is one that I really connected with on first watch. I was just amazed by all of the different layers to the story and how well developed all of the characters were. There's a lot of characters in this film, and yet you are fully invested in each one, and each one is just really well developed. And the performances are great. Leonardo DiCaprio, Vera Farmiga, Mark Wahlberg, Matt Damon, they're all so good in this. It's just overall a great crime film.
My last honorable mention I have is Wolfwalkers. I debated on whether this one was going to make my top 10 or not, honestly, because this is up there for one of my favorite animated films of all time, honestly, even for how new of a film it is. It is just such a great film. The animation is probably my favorite part of it. It is some of the most beautiful animation I've ever seen, and the music in it is really good as well, but it was definitely something that I couldn't take my eyes off the screen when I first saw it because I just thought it was so beautiful.
Yeah, that's a really beautifully done film for sure. And my last honorable mention is another coming of age film. You will probably see a couple more on this list. As you guys know, I love coming of age films, but this one's directed by Greta Gerwig and stars Saoirse Ronan, and that is Lady Bird. I was really looking forward to this movie going into it, but I was still really blown away by it. It exceeded all of my expectations. And even though it was her first film, this made Greta Gerwig one of my absolute favorite filmmakers. All of the performances in this film are just top notch. The dialogue is so well written and the cast is wonderful. Like I said, you have Saoirse Ronan, Laurie Metcalf, Timothée Chalamet, Tracy Letts. The list just goes on and on. It's just a great film with a wonderful cast, very relatable story. I think anyone can find something to relate to in the film. Yes, it's primarily about a mother-daughter relationship, but I think everyone can find something in there to relate to. And yeah, it's just one of my all-time favorite coming-of-age films and one that I could throw on at any time and enjoy. And now that I'm talking about it, I'm really surprised it didn't actually make my top 10, but yeah, I love Lady Bird.
Excellent film. So moving into our top 10 favorite films of all time, the first one on my list is Jaws. This is probably one of my favorite Spielbergs, one of my favorite horror films, and just all around cannot help but love this movie. The first time I saw it, it just terrified me. I'm still terrified of sharks in the ocean, honestly, because of it. And it is just a film that I can't help but watch over and over because I cannot get enough of the suspense in it, honestly.
Yeah, I think I was scared to go swimming in the swimming pool after seeing that for the first time.
Me too.
Yeah, that's a great movie. An iconic score in that one as well.
Mm-hmm.
The first film I'm going to mention is a film directed by Damien Chazelle, and that is Whiplash. I think this may be one of my absolute favorite theater experiences. But looking back on seeing Whiplash at Sundance Film Festival in 2013, it's just one of my all-time favorite memories. This film is amazing. It's a film about trying to be your absolute best and a very unhealthy relationship between a teacher and student, yet it is one of the most thrilling movies I think I've ever seen. It's a great character study, has one of the all-time best performances by J.K. Simmons, and just overall a fantastic movie. This one absolutely blew me away the first time I saw it. And even though I've seen it before, I'm still just as engaged and interested in the film as I was the first time I saw it. It's just a great movie.
Excellent film. That one blew me away too when we went and saw that. That was amazing.
Yeah, I'm so glad we saw that one at Sundance. That was so cool.
Yeah. The next one for me would have to be Alien. This was one when I first saw it just absolutely took my breath away. I had never seen such a perfect combination of two genres, honestly, because it is a great piece of science fiction while also being an amazing horror film as well. And the sheer isolation of it was just claustrophobic to no effect. And it still remains one of my very favorite science fiction pieces, honestly, just because it was so well made by Ridley Scott. I love rewatching it all the time.
Next on my list is a film directed by Dario Argento, and that is Suspiria. Sure, this comes as no surprise to anyone, including you.
Yeah.
This is one of my all-time favorite horror films. I actually just saw it for the first time maybe 4 or 5 years ago, and we were lucky enough to see it in theaters for our first time viewing, which was a really cool experience. It's such an immersive film with such a unique use of color and cinematography, and it's filled with just absolute dread throughout. Although you're not really sure what's going on throughout much of the film, you know that something is wrong and you're very worried about it the whole time, and it just holds you in suspense the entire runtime. Performances are great, and I can't talk about Suspiria without mentioning that incredible score by Goblin. I actually just listen to it all the time. It makes a nice background music for whatever I'm doing throughout the day, but that may seem a little strange, but that's just how I am. But yeah, I love Suspiria, and just one of my absolute favorite horror films. And it was also a great introduction to kind of Italian cinema and other types of horror beyond just the normal American fare. So I have to credit Suspiria with that for sure.
And I agree with you. Getting to see it for the first time on a big screen in a theater was just the perfect way to see it. It was just a wonderful experience and an amazing film all around.
Yeah, definitely.
Next for me would have to be Jurassic Park, which probably comes as no surprise to you, I'm sure.
No. That's hanging right over our bed. I knew that was coming.
Jurassic Park really hit me hard when I was young. And when I saw dinosaurs on the screen for the first time as a kid, it just took my breath away. It was the most amazing thing I'd ever seen. And on repeat viewings, honestly, that sense of wonder is still there just because they did such a phenomenal job in the special effects, especially in that movie. They still hold up so strongly today just because they used actual like animatronics and stuff for the majority of those shots. And it is just amazing work by Spielberg and his team. And the score to that movie is probably up there for one of my favorite John Williams soundtracks as well. It is just such an amazing film, and I'll never be able to get enough of that.
Yeah, I think all 90s kids can say that Jurassic Park was a big part of their childhood, because I definitely remember watching that quite a bit when I was young. Next up on my list is a film directed by Zach Braff, and that is Garden State. I've talked about this film briefly on the channel before, but this film just means a lot to me. I really love the characters in this film. They're very real feeling. You feel like you can really relate to them. Whether you relate more to Zach Braff's character or Natalie Portman's, that's kind of up to you, but there's just so much to love in this film. It's very well written. And like you mentioned with The Way, Way Back, it has that great indie film feel that's just really hard to replicate. And I feel like for a lot of people, Garden State was kind of their introduction to independent film because it was so successful when it came out. But yeah, I just absolutely love Garden State. It means a whole lot to me, and there's no way I can make my top 10 without this film on this list.
Yeah, I'm not surprised that one made your top 10 at all. That definitely has always been one of your favorites.
Yeah.
Next for me would be That Thing You Do. This is a movie I have enjoyed since childhood. It has always been a phenomenal film to me. Tom Hanks did such amazing work with that film, and it is just a wonderful, like, small story in a way, just following this small town band as they suddenly skyrocket to fame. And I think what shocked me even more was when years ago when I found out that there was a director's cut, I was like, wait, I can have more of this film? And that just made it even better for me.
Yeah, that's one you introduced to me, so.
Definitely up there. Just have always loved that film.
Yeah, that's a really underrated Tom Hanks film. Not enough people talk about it, for sure. And this one should come as no surprise to you, because just like Jurassic Park, this film is hanging over our bed, and that is Call Me By Your Name. I love this film. Even though it's not like the most happy film, for some reason it's just really comforting to me, and it's one of my go-to feel-good movies. I just think that the performances are wonderful. The chemistry between Armie Hammer and Timothée Chalamet is just unmatched. They really seem like they're falling in love, and it's a perfect example of romance. And then the performance by Michael Stolberg, who plays Timothée Chalamet's dad, is just absolutely unforgettable. There's one scene, which if you guys have seen the film, between the two characters, that is just incredible. It's one of the most moving scenes that I've ever seen in any movie. And then the score is really well done. It's one that I can throw crawl in at any time. It's just relaxing and nice to listen to. So yeah, I absolutely love Call Me By Your Name, and it's probably my favorite romance film.
Speaking of romance films, the next one I have is Moulin Rouge. I only first viewed this film a few years ago, but it instantly just grabbed my attention. It is a phenomenal film. The jukebox musical format is amazing. I absolutely adored it. And Baz Luhrmann's filming style for this particular film is just all over the place and crazy, and I absolutely love that about it. And it is just such an enjoyable film, and I love Ewan McGregor and Nicole Kidman in the leads. They are so cute together. And it's definitely one of my favorite romance films of all time.
Next up on my list is a film that I've talked about plenty of times on the channel, so it should come as no surprise to any of you, and that is Booksmart, directed by Olivia Wilde, starring Caitlin Dever and Beanie Feldstein.
No surprise at all.
Yes, I think this is probably my most rewatched film ever, save for maybe one other film that's going to be on this list. I just absolutely love this movie. The first time we saw it, I was laughing so hard, and I was just thinking to myself, gosh, I hope this movie is as funny as it is this time on future watches. And let me tell you, it definitely is. You almost find like a new thing to appreciate about it every time that you watch it. I think I've seen it 7 or 8 times. Needless to say, I absolutely love this movie. The performances are great. The characters are actually very realistic. There's a lot of high school movies that have really like cliched characters, but this is not one of them. These seem like kids that you could have gone to high school with. And yeah, the two main characters of Molly and Amy are just fantastic characters. Some of the best written high school characters I've ever seen. And I just can't wait to see what else Olivia Wilde does, because this movie was fantastic and definitely one of the funniest movies I've ever seen. And it still makes me laugh every time, just like it did the first time.
Yeah, I debated on having this one on my list as well. Oh. It was seriously a great film, and it was hilarious to no end. Yeah. It didn't quite make it for me, but I knew it would be on your list, so.
Yeah, if you guys have never watched it, you need to watch it right now, because it is hilarious. And don't call it the female super bad, because it is so much more than that. It's just, it's great. I love it.
The next one for me is Treasure Planet. This is probably one of my favorite Disney films of all time, and there's so much I love about it. I love the story of Treasure Island. It has always been a favorite of mine since I was a kid, and so a version of it set in space very much appealed to me. And then also the animation style, a mixture of 2D and 3D, and it was phenomenally done. I wish they had done more films like that, but it actually didn't go over well, apparently, even though it looked beautiful. And the score to this was just amazing. Still one of my favorite movie scores, and is such a wonderful film, and underrated, honestly. I wish more people talked about it, but it is just definitely up there for me for favorite Disney and favorite animation.
Next one for me is a film directed by David Fincher, and I kind of went back and forth on which David Fincher film I wanted to put on this list, but I feel like this is probably the one I go back to the most. And funny enough, it was actually the first one that I ever saw, and that is Gone Girl, which may come as a surprise to some of you that was the first one that I saw, but it came out in 2014, which was kind of around the time that I was just starting to get into film. And I hadn't seen any of his other films before, but I went to the theater and saw it just kind of on a whim and absolutely fell in love with it. I think this is one of the films that I can credit with making me really fall in love with film the way that I am today. The cinematography is so good. The score is just haunting. And of course, the performances are great. Rosamund Pike is so creepy and just very effective in this film. I don't know what else to say about it other than it's just a great mystery crime film that will just have you guessing from beginning to end. And on rewatch, it's still very enjoyable because you kind of put some of the puzzle pieces together that you hadn't quite put together before, or you may notice something that you hadn't the first time. But either way, it's still really engaging to watch on repeat viewings. And yeah, I just absolutely love Gone Girl. I love a lot of David Fincher films, but again, this is the one that I probably revisit the most.
The next one for me might be a bit of a cheat because it's technically 3 movies.
I know where this is going.
But they all go together, and that is The Lord of the Rings. This is my favorite film series, and these 3 movies make up this amazing story all put together. And that's the only way, of course, that I'll watch them, is I have to sit down and watch all three in a row, because it's just one big story. I don't ever think of it as three separate films, honestly.
Yeah, I think you're glad that I work 12-hour shifts for that reason, because you can just sit at home and watch all of the Lord of the Rings movies while I'm gone.
Perfect window of opportunity, honestly. But seriously, one of my favorite entries into the fantasy genre is just epic in scope. The music is phenomenal. The actors do an amazing job of bringing the characters to life, and just seriously, again, one of my favorite series of all time.
And no, I still won't watch them. All right, next on my list is a film directed by Noah Baumbach, and that is Frances Ha. This is another film that I saw pretty early on in my film journey, and it really blew me away. The cinematography is wonderful. It's all shot in black and white, but it looks so great. And it's not like a hokey use of black and white. I feel like it really adds to the story and adds to the fact that it's a very personal film. And Greta Gerwig is so great in this film. Even though her character is a little bit over the top, it still feels very real and very grounded. And it's one of my go-to feel-good films. Like I've mentioned before, I love to just sit down and watch movies that make me feel good and remind me of good things in life, and this is definitely one of them. And I love watching her journey throughout the film, and the growth that her character goes through is just wonderful. Noah Baumbach is really good at character development and writing really believable stories and character arcs, and yeah, this movie is no exception. It's a great film.
Next one for me would be How to Train Your Dragon, which I'm sure comes as no surprise to you.
No.
This one is probably up there for one of my favorite animated films of all time. I probably saw I think three times while it was in the theaters, and it still just has stuck with me all these years later. It was phenomenal. I love the music to it. I loved the story. I love stuff that involves dragons especially, but this one was just such a unique take on the aspect of dragons, and I absolutely loved it. I loved the whole series, but the first one especially really stuck with me, and I've always enjoyed it, and I love watching it again and again. It is just a magical film, honestly.
Of course, I had to include a film by one of my favorite directors, Denis Villeneuve, and the film that I chose for this list is Arrival. This is definitely my favorite sci-fi film of all time. It is just a thought-provoking, profound film that will really make you think about life and what is important to you. And the performances, I know I say this over and over again, but obviously that's something I really appreciate in film, and the performances are wonderful. How Amy Adams doesn't have an Oscar yet, I have no clue. This is definitely a film that she deserved an Oscar for, because her performance is very understated but very powerful at the same time. And this film kind of starts out as one thing and then in the middle changes to something completely different, and I won't go into that too much because I don't want to spoil it, but it's a really, like I said, profound film and just one that will really make you think. And one thing I forgot to mention about it is the cinematography is beautiful. It's such a visual treat to look at, and the score by Johan Johansson is so great. It's one of my favorite film scores for sure.
An amazing film for sure. An excellent entry in sci-fi. And you're right, it is profound and it really just makes you sit back and think about things. The next one for me would be Midnight in Paris. This was the first Woody Allen film I ever saw. It was so enjoyable. It was very set in the real world, but had just the slightest sci-fi twist to it with a bit of time travel. And it was such a unique little story, honestly, and I absolutely adored it. And anything set in Paris, honestly, really gets to me. And it was just a really good film all around. And I was lucky enough to see that one in theaters, actually, when it came through. And I just enjoyed it so much. It really is probably my favorite Woody Allen film.
My next choice would be John Carpenter's Halloween. There's no way I could make a favorite films list and not have this one on there. This film is so important to my film journey and my love of film. This is the first horror film I really remember seeing when I was little, and it's one that we watched every year around Halloween in my household. We all just absolutely love this film, and for good reason. It is the best slasher of all time. One of the best directed horror films, with just a haunting score, great performances for a slasher film, and just overall a fantastic movie.
I was waiting for that one to show up on your list. I would have been shocked if it had not been on your list. That is seriously such an amazing film, honestly. When you introduced it to me, I was floored by just how amazing it was. You're right, it is the best slasher of all time. The last one I have is About Time. This is also up there for one of my favorite romance films. It is a great blend of romance, comedy, and just the slightest bit of science fiction as well. I don't know what it was about that film, but when we saw it, it just really hit all the right buttons for me, and I absolutely adore this film. And Domhnall Gleeson and Rachel McAdams are just adorable together. It was such a wonderful film, and I love watching it again and again.
Yeah, I really like Bill Nighy in that film as well. He's really great there. One of my favorite romance films of all time, for sure. And the last film I'm going to mention, this will come as no surprise to any of you, and that is The Perks of Being a Wallflower. For many years, this has been kind of my go-to film as my favorite, and for good reason. It's a perfectly directed coming-of-age film with some of the best performances I've ever seen in this genre of film. And I credit this film with being the reason that I love film as much as I do today. This film really changed my perspective on what filmmaking and storytelling can be. It's just so well done, and it's one of my number one go-to films. I can watch this film at any time and really enjoy it. And I have to credit this film with making me fall in love with the music of the Smiths, so there's that as well.
I was gonna say, the soundtrack in that film is astounding.
Yeah, great 90s soundtrack for sure. A wonderful film overall. So that is our top 10 favorite films of all time.
Along with the honorable mentions as well.
Yeah, I'm sure we could add plenty more to that list.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that was a fun challenge for sure.
Yeah, this was definitely a fun exercise in trying to decide what films have definitely stuck with us and have influenced us as much as they have in our love of film and just our overall journey.
Yeah, ask us tomorrow and we'd probably come up with a bunch of different ones. But just know that we love all of the films that we mentioned in this video, because we definitely do.
Yes.
Real quick, we have to give a shout out to our executive producer patron, Chase Wilson. Thank you so much. And thank you to our other patrons that have signed up. If you guys are interested in signing up for our Patreon, check out the link below. We will be adding more stuff to it as time goes on, and we're definitely willing to listen to your feedback on the types of perks you want to see on there.
Also down below, if any of you guys are interested, we have created some merch, which we're really excited for you guys to see. Hopefully we'll be able to get some soon to show off for you as well.
And there are a few other links below if you guys are interested in supporting our channel in other ways. But as always, we just appreciate you guys being here.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and we will see you on the next one.
See ya.